Good morning, everyone. Welcome to this meeting of the Koochiching County Board of Commissioners to order. We're actually in the third floor courtroom. So we're maintaining our social distancing and we've got our face masks. Wish we could write it.
Mr. Chair, I guess, you know, with acoustics in this room, I would just please ask everybody to speak real loud, especially through your mask.
Yeah.
And some of us are a little bit older than some other people and don't hear real well. So, thank you.
Okay. First thing we'll do is that the pledge of allegiance. Sorry about that.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
First thing is to approve the agenda with additions.
Mr. Chair, if I may, I have two additions. Two airport legislators that need to be approved. We don't need signatures today. The city's approving them, and then we'll get that original document, and then Kyler will get signatures from yourself and the county attorney.
Motion to the board. Motion by Commissioner McBride, second by Commissioner Schoenbaum. Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
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 Any opposed? Motion is carried. COVID-19 update. Kathy.
Good morning.
Morning.
We are currently at, Koochiching County, we're currently at 111 cumulative cases, still remaining at 3 deaths. Everybody has noticed, I'm sure, that the count is rising quite quickly. We're 2 weeks out from the Labor Day weekend holiday, so that's not surprising, really. It's unfortunate and disappointing, but it's not surprising. The same thing happened after the 4th of July weekend. In Koochiching County, there's been 2,858 tests, and as of last week, we were at a 3.7% positive, but that was when we were at 98 cases as well. Last week there was 91 cases no longer needing isolation.
Kevin, how many in the county right now are there?
There's 111
how many
cases.
Are there?
Well, my guess would be about 20.
20?
Yeah. That's kind of a rough estimate, though, because I don't know how many came off as from last Thursday. But with the 13 new cases, yeah, that would be about right.
The last spike, Kathy, you hear is because of the labor weekend?
Yes, absolutely.
Any other questions or anything for Kathy? All right, thank you, Kathy.
Welcome.
Approve September 15th, 2020 minutes.
Move, Mr. Chair.
A motion by Schoenbaum.
Second.
Second by Skoy. Any discussion? Hearing none, call for the vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion is carried. Financial business.
Mr. Chair, I'll move on A, B, and C.
I will second the motion.
Okay, got my motion by Schoenbaum, second by McBride. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion is carried. Human resource business.
Good morning.
Hey, Janelle.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I have a notice of hire today for a part-time dispatcher correction officer, which he is starting. I think it might have reflected that he was supposed to start today, but there has been a change in his start date to next Monday, the 28th.
Thank you, Kevin. Or thank you, Janelle.
better do it quick before he changes his mind.
Or we do.
I told Tom he's supposed to swear me in, not swear at me. That's what I'm used to with people.
Yeah, I know. For the equalization, right? Okay, Len, when we're done here, I'll meet you to sign this, and then I sign it, and then we'll seal it and send it to the powers that be, and we'll record the castle. Okay, so.
Excuse me. Do we want to make the motion first and then do the oath of office?
We need a motion?
Yep, to appoint him for the next 4 years.
We do that.
We need a motion? Okay.
Well, we do vote, make it.
Second.
Okay. Yeah, motion by Heather, second by McGrady. Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion is carried.
I, Len Peterson,
do solemnly swear or affirm,
do solemnly do swear and affirm,
that I will support the Constitution of the United States,
that I will support the Constitution of the United States,
and the Constitution of the State of Minnesota,
and the Constitution of the State of Minnesota,
and that I will discharge,
discharge.
Faithfully the duties of the office of the county assessor. In the county of Koochiching. The state of Minnesota. To the best of my judgment and abilities.
Yeah.
Thanks, Len. Thank you. We'll put a sign here.
Thank you all once again for we've had fun halfway.
It's official.
We're glad you're hanging in here.
Me too. I'll see you later. Thank you, Len.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thursday, so I think she's, I'm sure there is one.
Okay.
So you want approval of it?
Yeah.
I move to approve her.
Got a motion by Commissioner McBride, hold on a second. Second by Commissioner Skoye. Discussion. Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion is carried.
You're going to stamp this? No, I can stamp. You can sign those, but Bob, it doesn't matter. I stamp them all, but I can stamp the burial if I need to.
Okay, yeah. These are just the vultures that I have.
This is court's going to raise the careful for you.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Kind of quit now. I don't know who it was, but they heard there's something that they heard.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's on the way.
Maybe they got their tax bill or something.
Okay, environmental service does us.
September 10th to hold a public hearing on the combined parcel rezoning and conditional use permit application. The proposed parcel is located approximately 2.5 miles south of the city of Northville, lying north of State Highway 1 and approximately 400 feet west of the intersection of State Highway 71. As per the application, the project consists of Lakes Gas Company installing an 18,000 gallon bulk propane storage tank to be used for refilling company trucks. After representatives from Lakes Gas Company provided information and answered questions, and after hearing no opposition to proposed rezoning and conditional use, the Planning and Zoning Commission unanimously recommended to approve the rezoning and conditional use permit application as submitted and further to the board's action here today. If you'd like, I did provide a staff report in the paperwork that I provided. I could go over that information if you'd like. I'll let you know, the applicant is Lakes Gas Company, and the property owner is Lance T. Pink. And again, it's for refilling of their trucks to provide propane service in the North Home area.
I'll second Wayne's motion. By Skoye, second by Padilla. Any discussion?
I figured you know what
that would. We would need two motions, one for rezoning and the other for conditional use permit.
I think we could have one motion for both its combined parcel rezoning and conditional use permit.
Any further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion is carried.
Thank you.
Thank you, Matt.
A lot easier.
Okay, we have Highway Department business. Okay, what I'd like to do, the Highway Department would like to request that we get a resolution of support for the Minnesota Highway Freight Program application for US Highway 53 and Cassad 332 roundabout funding. The preliminary estimate on the project is $2.25 million, with 80% of the funding from Minnesota Highway Freight Program and 20% from the county's Cassad funding. So we've got a resolution here. Should I read the resolution? Anyways, we'd be working with MnDOT, the federal government, to implement this program. Basically, the freight program has funds available for fiscal year 2023, 2024, and 2025. The project is eligible for the funding. Real quickly, we've asked for letters of support from a number of entities. We've already got some of those back.
Resolution from the board to say that we're interested in the application.
The application is due Monday.
Commissioner Bauer, I want to thank our highway engineer and staff for putting all the work in to get this going. I mean, it's something that is needed. And,
I'm just going to caution everybody. I mean, we're coming into this program late. We don't have any engineering. Thanks to Wayne and the timber producers, we're going to get an application in. Thanks for the letters of support. You know,
we're doing the best we can.
Yeah, and there will be other funding opportunities if this one doesn't work. And I think there will be something out there someday. And I think, but I'll tell you what, so the crash data says it isn't a high crash area. There's only been 6 accidents out there, only once. Serious injury, and then I think there's been one minor injury, and the rest of them are property damage. So, but again, like Wayne tells you, when you're coming out of the falls and you look up that way, you can only see about 1,000 feet, and by the time you try to cross with a heavy load and a long load, you really can't get across that intersection. So everybody's running.
Commissioner, if I could, I'm just wondering, would it help if the timber producers or other organizations would weigh in on this too as
well? I think they have, and they're having their annual meeting a couple weeks, and I know it's on their agenda.
Good.
And they did meet up here, I think you were there, weren't you, Dave, when they had a meeting at the pizza place?
What?
I don't know, were you there when the timber producers had that meeting at the pizza place? Well, okay, or maybe Trent was there. But anyhow, it's been on their radar.
Yep.
And then I'm sure that the MFI, the Forest Resources people would do it. But I did talk to them, and they would definitely put in support for the resolution.
Yeah, we've already got letters of support from the sheriff, PCA. I expect one from the timber producers, Acklin.
Yeah.
So. Some of the other trucking outfits, all the Hershey.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. And like you said, it is the main route coming in and out of town. And
I went so far in the application to say it's the main freight route to the international border.
Yeah.
Because there's 155, that is the quickest, shortest way if you don't want to stop in town.
Yeah. Are there any members of opposition, Dave?
Opposition?
Yeah.
I don't think there, I talked to Ken Anderson. I don't think there is. This is about freight. It isn't about diverting all traffic.
That right now.
And really, Highway 53 is going to get narrower. You can already see that. And do you want all those trucks on there?
Yeah.
I don't think so.
No, I agree.
Yeah. And I was going to run over, because I know in Thief River on Highway 59, I think it is,
mm-hmm.
They put a couple in Thief River, but then over the weekend we went down to New York Mills, and on Highway 71, just south of Park Rapids, they have a roundabout. That's at just before they come to where their county garage and all the buildings are, they have one there, and that's a major commerce, you know, trucker up there too. So.
And it takes people a little while to get used to them, but I didn't like them at first. I mean, but as soon as I start understanding what you're supposed to do, I mean.
Yeah.
You don't stop.
Yeah, right now. Yeah. And the thing is, the complaints on some of them that one half of the rapids, they're just built too small. And you know, it just bottled everything together, and I know all the trucks are having to drive over the curb.
Yeah.
You know, to get around it. But I know I heard about them when the first time I saw them, and some buddies of mine when they lived out east said, just don't stop or slow down, just keep going, and you just keep going.
If you miss your turn, just go around the circle.
Yeah, makes sense. Just go around and do it again.
Well, I know that they put that big roundabout on that exit in the bouquet out 35. And I know a person from International Falls, when they just completed that, came out 35 at about 70 miles an hour, right over the top of the circle. But anyway. Yeah, I think we've all had experience that I don't like them, but after you get on a couple of times, you realize how safe they are and they move traction.
Yeah.
To me, the biggest thing is the safety factor. I mean, it's just a matter of time before something terrible happens.
Well, say, Dave, something else on that. When you come into that, because it slows the traffic down, does that traffic remain slow all the way to town now then, or is that going to go back up to 60?
I'll let Michelle figure that out. I assume they'll have the traffic speed back up to about 40. I don't think it will be 60 again, but.
Yeah, right. Because I think coming into Park Rapids there, that you know, when it slowed down, of course, we turned and went around town, so I'm not sure, but I would assume at that point that they dropped it from 60 to, you know, to 45 or something.
If you're still from that corner to where it reduces to 50, three quarters of a mile at least.
It's almost a mile exactly.
Did we have a motion on this?
No, but I'll move on if you
want. I'll second Wayne's motion to support resolution.
Got a motion by Wayne, second by Brian. Is there any further discussion?
See what happens.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a ways down the road, and like Dave said, it's going to take a lot of engineering, but I think it's going to be a good program.
All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion is carried. Thank you, Dave.
Yep, thank you.
When will they start on that? Do you have any idea?
What?
When will they start on that? Do you have any idea?
Well, they asked us when we want funding, and I told them I'm going to put the application in 2024. We've got to do the engineering, we've got to do this intersection conflict evaluation. When I talked to MnDOT, they thought that would work, so we were asking for 24.
Okay.
A couple other things, 103, they should start paving next week. I don't know if you heard that yet.
Yeah, they're out there doing the pin slopes and everything today, so yeah. That'll be wonderful. Hopefully the weather holds. Yeah.
And we've got final word that, you know, we weren't successful on the bonding, right? But Bill Craig.
Yeah, a little ground. Did you hear anything about the bonding from yesterday?
No, it basically, right now, they had a blackout period where they couldn't really talk about the bonding bill because they were looking at the funds and stuff like that. And that ended yesterday. So now they can move on it if they want to, but, you know, with all elections, COVID stuff, I sort of think bonding bill is dead for this year. But you can ask that one, but I don't see, it's just getting it too close to the election. You'll see another special session here in about 20 some days when the governor needs to redo his emergency powers, but that's going to be way too close to the election, I think.
So don't go out of the house yet.
I know the AMC flyers are all coming out to get on your legislature to get it done, but I don't see how they can do it. No.
All right. Thanks, Greg.
Thank you.
Thank you.
David, when does the outreach start? When does the mail outreach start?
I have to look in the calendar. I think the third. It's that first weekend.
October. You're going to go for 10 days?
And it's supposed to go for 2 weeks.
They're not going to want you back for those 2 weeks.
No, they're going to want me back for 3 days.
Really?
So I'll send something to Jenny and say I'll be out on vacation, but you need to get a hold of me. And you got Trent, so you guys are.
A lot of people are looking for you, so that's okay.
Wow. Well, yeah. That's a whole other story.
Well, we sure appreciate the work you do here, so thank you.
Thanks, yeah, thanks.
Bye.
So anybody here from public comment? Nobody. Okay, I'll ask for a motion to adjourn.
Cool.
Motion by Pavlik, second by Sherlock.
What? That came to life first.
All in favor?
Aye.